across. Where the glass is at? What the? Oh, here we go.
Wow. This is trippy. This is crazy. You see me wearing these glasses right here? For some reason, these swimming goggles break up the light. And it turns into, what I'm seeing right now is the actual visible color spectrum. Like, it's like, I'm seeing the light, white light being broken up by these glasses. These glasses actually breaking up the light. Or these goggles, I should say. And actually allowed me to see Roy G. Viv. This is crazy. This is crazy. Like, I've never noticed this before with any other, like, swimming glasses or swimming goggles. It's the first time I've noticed this. It's very disorienting, though, I will say that. But this painting right here is actually a request about late last year. I posted a video on Instagram saying that I had a few canvases left and what should I paint next, right? Like, what should be next that I should paint? And someone commented that I should paint Pocahontas, the Native American girl. I said, really? Pocahontas? He said, yeah, you know, it'd be different. It's just something unique, something unusual that I've not, that, you know, it'll just be something, a new thing to do, challenge. I said, you know what? Okay. I can dig that. It's a challenge. I'll go with it. So, after I finished a few other paintings that I've done and posted that are for sale. I figured, you know what, I'm actually trying. I'm actually do that. But I didn't want to do the typical Disney version of Pocahontas. Because a lot of people don't know, especially a lot of kids don't know, that Disney story, Pocahontas, was loosely based on an actual person. Pocahontas was an actual real girl. John Smith, all that stuff, that was an actual event that happened. However, it did not happen as it is portrayed in the Disney movie. What you see in the Disney movie, is that actually what truly happened. The characters were real, but the events were slightly, very much altered. Okay? So, what I wanted to do was paint an accurate depiction of the girl known as Pocahontas. Well, she died as a young woman. She died in her 20s, actually. Like, she actually died in her 20s. So I wanted to do an actual portrayal of her. You know. What about the paints? Let's see. So I wanted to do an accurate portrayal of her. You know, so what I did was, I looked up the actual tribe that she was from, because she's from an actual tribe. You know, it's not like no, you know, a made up thing. The tribe that she was from is a real tribe. I don't know if it still exists now, but the tribe she is from was based, was settled in Virginia. It's called the Pocahontas tribe. It's another name for it. It's like Pocahontas, and it's another name for her tribe. So, I looked up the tribe, and what I did was I looked up the dress, like the what they would wear back during the time of Pocahontas and John Smith, and also what they wear now. So, I believe she was a princess, like she was the daughter of the chief. I was like, okay, is there a formal wear for like a princess or the daughter of a chief? Do they have like a certain type of garment that they wear? So I looked it up, and to my surprise, that's one of the things that Disney did get correct, was actually the dress of something that Pocahontas would wear. Like, they had clothing, obviously, but was the clothing historically accurate? And to my surprise, yes, I looked it up. I looked up the dress that a young woman would wear from that tribe, from that Native American tribe, from that indigenous tribe. I won't say Native America. It was real Native America during that time. During that time period, and I was like, okay, is it historically accurate? And to my surprise, it was. The dress you see Pocahontas wear, by dressing in attire, that you see Pocahontas wear in the movie, the Disney movie, is accurate. That's what she would have worn. So I said, okay. But you see, I'm doing a headshot. But that's something that I found interesting. Let's see, what else? I found the tribe, where the tribe is located. The tribe is located in Virginia. You know, it was located in Virginia. And like I said, Pocahontas isn't her name. Actually, Pocahontas is like a nickname for her. Her nickname actually means kind of like troublemaker. The word Pocahontas means troublemaker. So that's also interesting that the name that we know her as is actually a nickname for. I forgot her actual name. And the story is very, very interesting. Like, the story has a lot more into it than a lot of us know. And that Disney, I'm pretty sure Disney, when they researched the story of Pocahontas, they knew about her actual story. Like, what happened to her when she went to England, you know, with John Smith and all that stuff. Like, there's a lot of stuff that happened in her real life that Disney did not say. And trust me when I tell you, if you were to actually know what happened to the actual girl Pocahontas in her life, and why, you know, why she went with John Smith and his whole story and all that stuff, man, you would not look at that movie the same way. I promise you that. You will not look at Pocahontas the same way. I promise you. There's a whole lot of things going on in that story that if I was Disney, I wouldn't put either. I wouldn't put in that movie either. To be all the way real with you. Like, for one thing, in the movie, they show Pocahontas as kind of like me, like a girl in her her maybe late teens, early 20s, right? That's how she's depicted in the movie. And with the whole thing about her and John Smith and all that stuff, she's depicted as a woman. However, in the actual story of Pocahontas, during the time when she meets John Smith and all that stuff, she's a teenager. I believe she's 14. When she meets John Smith, and that whole thing happened where the chief was going to kill John Smith, she's actually, historically, she's actually 14. She's actually 14. She goes, and thing is, she goes to back to England with John Smith to save her people. But she was not treated nice. I mean, that's as nice as I can possibly put it. She was not treated nice. She went through a lot. Rape and molestation and all that stuff and disease. And she actually ended up dying. She died when she was in her 20s. I think she died at like 20, 23 or 24. She died very young. Now, does that sound like a Disney story to tell? Someone like that, and they died like at age 21, like in their early 20s. She was in her early 20s when she died. That's crazy, ain't it? Crazy. And I said, wow, like, I bet you any amount of money, Disney would never, ever show the historically accurate version of Pocahontas. Never. That would be career suicide if they did that. If Disney said, you know what, we're gonna reshoot Pocahontas, and we're gonna shoot it the accurate, you know, accurate depiction of Pocahontas. Man, they would shut that movie down. But you know what? Maybe not, because they show slave movies like there's no problem. So if they show slave movies with no issue, they just might show Pocahontas. They just might. But, yeah, that movie, read her actual story. Read, like, the news of that time and what happened when she arrived to England. Read that. About one part of this. This is a part I forgot about. Where's the okay? I'm just putting in more of the details of it, of her dress. Is how she actually would look. see, what else? Okay, that's accurate. A little bit of the shadows. And the image right here is actually of a woman staring into the sun. She's staring into the sun. Come in. Come in. Come in.
Up?
Yes.
Oh, you're making a video.
What do you want?
And Brianna told me to tell you, can you test me?
Test you on the words?
Yeah.
Okay. Give me the paper.
Huh?
Give me the paper. I can multitask.
Hmm?
I can multitask. Give me the paper. I don't need the phone. Give me the paper.
I practiced on the paper.
Just give me the paper. No, give me the actual worksheet where you took numbers, your words on there. What is that? Give me that. That's part of your homework. Always teaching. Okay. Lore.
Lore?
Yes, lore. Yes.
L
like a cure.
C-U-R-E.
Good. Hurt.
H-U-R-T.
Okay. Now I want you to say the word, spell it, then say the word again, okay? Alright. Curve.
Curve.
Curve. Curve.
Mm-hmm,
curve.
C-U-R-E.
I said say the word first, spell it, then say it again.
I did say it first.
Okay, good.
C.
I know it sounds weird, but, you know, go with what you remember.
C-U-R.
Okay, good.
V-E. Curve.
Okay, good. Let's see. Burp.
Burp. B. U. R. P. Burp.
Okay. Let's see. Turtle.
T. T-U-R-T-E. Turtle.
Okay. Don't forget that part. Don't forget that. Say the word again. Let's see. Turbo.
Turbo. T-U-R-B-O. Turbo.
Good. Let's see. Burst.
Burst. B U R S T first.
Curl.
C curl. C U R L E. L.
Spell it again. Do it again.
C.
Don't say the word again.
Here. Curl. C-U-R-L. Curl.
Very good. Nurse.
Nurse. N-U-R-S-E. Nurse.
Very good. Let's see. Creature.
C. Creature. C R E A T U R E. Creature.
Very good. Hold on. Let's see. Lure. Cause you didn't do the word thing again. Lure.
L. Lure. L. U. R. E. Lure.
Okay. Cure.
Cure. C-U-R-E. Cure.
Okay. Hurt.
Hurt. H-U-R-T. Hurt.
Okay. Now, do you remember the next word? Don't look at the pun. Do you remember the next word?
No.
Okay. Curve.
C. Curve. C. U.
Remember that. I don't remember to say the word. Go ahead. Go ahead.
C. U. R. V. E. Curve.
Okay. Burp.
Burp. B. U. R. P.
Okay. Say it louder.
Burp.
Okay. Let's see. Turtle.
T. Turtle. T. U. R. T. L. E.
Close the door, please. Close the door. Go. All right, go ahead. All right. Did you spell it? Mm-hmm. Did you say the word again?
Yeah. Okay.
Turbo.
T turbo. T U R B O. Turbo.
Okay. Let's see. Burst.
B. Burst.
Okay.
B. U. R. S. T. Burst.
Okay. Curl.
Curl. C. U. R. A. Curl.
Okay. A nurse.
Nurse. N U R S E. Nurse.
Okay. And creature.
Creature.
Creature is watching.
C R E A T U R E. Creature.
Creature, okay. Now, do you know why I keep asking you to say the word first, then spell it, then say it again? Okay. What I want you to do is I want you to, when you hear a word, it helps you spell the word. We actually can hear the letters, each sound of the letter. When I say creature, when you say it, you can hear it out loud, you can spell it, because now you know which sound goes with what letter. Then when you say creature after you spell it, it just sticks in your mind again. Okay, every time I hear this word, I should know the letters that go with it. Right here, burst. As soon as I say burst, my brain will tell me what letters go with those sounds. When I say it again, it'll stick it to my brain. So every time I hear the word burst, I automatically go B-U-R-S-T. Automatically. The more you do it, when you write it three times, every time you write something down, it helps your brain to remember how it looks. So now you can see B-U-R-S-T. Then when you say the word, you hear how it sounds. You say it again, it sticks in your brain. So now you read it, you say it, and you write it. Those are the three ways that people remember things. You see something when you read it, you say it when you speak it, and you write it down. The more you do that, the more you remember something. Alright? Good job. So if you have school tomorrow, if they don't still close down, if you have school tomorrow, Just remember that every time you see a word, say the word first, spell it out, say it again. Or you could just say the word, spell it out, or write it down, say it again. What?
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Are you good? Are you good?
You did very good. You did excellent. You didn't mess up at all. You good. So I'm done for now. See how this looks. Alright, that's how it looks so far. Catch y'all later. Peace.